Hello. A little over a year ago, I bought a new 24-70mm lens. I bought the Tamron 24-70 f2.8 G2 version. I put a link down below to the technical specifications of this lens. In this video, I want to show you up close the hardware bits and a couple of pictures that I took with this lens because it is really a good lens. So let's have a look. So let me show you a couple of things. This is the lens. And the lens hood clicks on. It has a, where is it? Clicking system. So, there we go. Click. And it doesn't come off. I mean, if you want to have it off, push the button. And it comes off. Nice front element. And this one. It's okay. The one I bought was a replacement one. And it's this one. I think it's only $2. Then again, it's a Tamron. So, the other thing is this lock. So it states 24. Another button. Autofocus. VC on, VC off. So if you want to do from autofocus to manual focus and image stabilization on or off. Nice rubbery ring. As you can see, I've been using this lens, well, I've been using this lens pretty much every day. It stays on the body. Yep, I know, I'm not gonna take it off. So that's the 24-70 f2.8 VC G2 version. Now I will show you the pictures I took over the last couple of months with this lens. Okay, here we are in Adobe Raw. I have a selection that I want to open up. Let's first do the lens correction. There you are. Coffee beans. There it is. Coffee beans. Auto. When we look at sharpness at 50%, we see how sharp this lens actually is. I shot it at f10, 70 millimeters. ISO 100, and you can actually see the fibers over here and the fiber over there. And what else do I see? Well, it's tech sharp. Next one. Logs in the forest. It is wood. Boom. Okay, where? Zoom. 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 And it's sharp. Shot at f8, ISO 320, 48 millimeters. This one, there it is even better. Look at this. f8, 166. Let's see it up close. 100%. Boom, there it is. Yeah, looks nice. But this one, shot at f2.8, 100 ISO, 66 millimeters. When you zoom in on this one, just look out,
look at the bokeh and the sharpness. This is a sharp lens. See? Great. Shot it at f8, 100 ISO, 70 millimeters. 21%, 50%. Well, they are moving, so they're unsharp. 100, and you can still see how sharp this lens is. And then you're looking at it at 1080p, right? I mean, not even at this one, f4, ISO 100, 24 millimeters. This is shot from the hip, actually early in the morning from the hip. Did I do that one? Okay. 50, 100, there it is. Just look at it, looks amazing. And you're now looking at it at low resolution. So when you see this at 6K, where it was shot at, it looks amazing. In print, wow. Of all the pictures, this one is my favorite. It's a horse, of course. F5, ISO 400, 55 millimeters. Look at it. Okay, here we go. Boom. 33, 50, 66. That's sharp, folks. Just look at it. And 100. That looks sharp. Focusing is fit to view. Focusing is fast. It never misfocuses or gets wrong focus or goes hunting. It just does what it needs to do. I picked this lens over the Nikon because the Nikon was much more expensive and well, bottom line, I can't afford that. So I picked this one and I'm really, really, really happy with it. I have it about 90% of the time on my D750 body, and I'm happy. I'm really happy with this lens. If you want to see technical details about this lens, want to read up on reviews from other owners, I have links below to Amazon, and that's where you can check the lens that I actually bought, reviews from others, and just, well, go from there.